Hello everyone, welcome to the tutorials of HDPS Smart. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create an item in HDPS Smart. Firstly, click on Setup button. From the first page of Setup, click on Item Module and then click on Add Item. This will open Add New Item window. Barcode. This is an auto-generated barcode number and it keeps on increasing as you go on creating items. If you want to define your own barcode, click on Define My Own and you can enter your barcode. Otherwise, click on Auto Generate button. The barcode of the item has to be unique. You can define multiple barcodes to one item using alternate barcode, which will be covered up in further videos. Name. Here you can enter the item name. Item name template. In HDPS Smart, it is important to have your item name as unique names. This way you can easily maintain stock of each of your item. For example, in a garment store, you can have items like shirts, trousers, t-shirts, jeans, etc. But each of this would have a different size, brand, color, material. This can be easily handled by using a combination of additional information along with the item name and category through our item template feature. So if you click on item name template, so this will be my item name and you can double click on the category. So the item name will be displayed as the item name followed by the category name. Item group name. By default, it takes the item name as group name if no template is defined. Group name is useful for eShop users. By providing a group name, you can group similar items together. Name in regional language. Here you can enter the item name in your regional language. To enter in your regional language, you have to download Microsoft Indic language tool for respective language. Or you can download the font from the internet and change the font. To change the font, click on the settings. Click on all documents. And then click on change font. Here you can select the fonts that are installed in your computer. Category. Here you have to select the category to which this item belongs. To select the category or create a new category, click on the three dotted button. This will open Category Manager. Click on Add Category. Enter the category name. Click on Create. Select the category and click on OK. Search code. Here you can enter any short code of the item. This will be useful to select the items quickly by entering the search code. Item attributes. If you are creating a normal item, in the sense you are purchasing and selling the same item, then you don't have to change anything here. Detailed explanation of each attributes will be covered in further videos. In tax details section, you can select the tax that will be applied while purchasing and selling this item. To select tax, click on the three dotted button. This will open Tax Manager. To create a new tax, click on Add Tax. Enter the tax name. Enter the tax value. Click on Add. Select the tax and click on OK. Select the tax that is collected while selling. In packaging section, we can select the measuring unit while purchasing and selling this item. By default, it shows quantity as measuring unit. If the purchase and sales measuring units are different, then you need to enter the conversion factor. In pricing section, you can enter the last purchase unit price. And here you have the option to enter the sales price before tax or after tax. If you want to enter the sales price before tax, then you need to uncheck this checkbox and you can enter the sales price. Then you can enter the MRP, which is nothing but the maximum retail price, or you can leave it blank. On the left, you can attach any photo to this item by clicking on Add Photo. Select the image and click on Open. This photo has been attached to this item. If you want to add any opening stock of the item, You can do that by clicking on Add Opening Stock, where you need to select the business location, enter the quantity that you want to add as opening stock, and you need to select the godown keyword and accessory keywords. You can enter the value here only if you are using online shop services. Keywords entered here will be useful in finding the related products in your online shop. Item description. In item description, you can enter any details about this item. If you want to add any additional field that is not available here, you can do that by creating item user fields by going into the settings. Detailed explanation of item user field will be covered in further videos. To save the item details, click on Create button. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.